I am currently pursuing PhD in management. I am associated with MCKV Institute of Engineering for the last 9.5 years. I would be completing 10 years in July this year as well in MCKV. I have done my schooling from Vidhan School, Durgapur. I have done my plus two from Vidhan Chandra Institution in Commerce. I have done my graduation, BCom Honours from Raj College, Burdwan. MCom regular from Burdwan University. Therein, I have done my MBA, PGDM from Boston Business School. I have qualified in UGC NET in Management just 2 years ago. And now I'm pursuing PhD. I am here associated currently as the head of the Department of Management, Science and Humanities. MBA is a part or stream within the Management, Science and Humanities Department, as well as I am the coordinator of the MBA department here.
All right, sir. In your department, MBA, what are the offerings that provide research facilities and internships and projects for the students?
Yeah, our entire curriculum has been developed by the best of the academicians from the best of the B schools that deals with business analytics, like BITS Pilani, like IIM Bangalore, like ISM Dhanbad, like Stewart School of Business, like Sharda University, and entire 4-semester curriculum. There are enough opportunities for project and research in the search methods project, BRM project, wherein the student need to write an entire detailed management oriented paper with using softwares like SPSS, Python, and R. After the first year curriculum, the students will be undergoing an 8-week internship in an organization dealing with data and analytics. That's a summer internship. As well as in third sem, project management is a core curriculum itself. To round up, in the final semester, there is a capstone or final project that engulfs the entire curriculum. Plus, there is a dissertation and viva based on it. So there are enough research and internship opportunities that have been focused upon in this entire 2-year curriculum. Okay, so that's it.
Yes, sir. That gives a very good insight into what the growth opportunities are for students there. So moving on to the next question, how does the department bridge the gap between theoretical and practical learning?
Yes, look, this is our first batch of MBA and Business Analytics in our college. Now, faculties are regularly instructed to deal with case studies and real organizational issues that take place in the industry to bridge the gap between theory and the requirement of the industry. And as told to you, we have an entire 8-week strong summer internship program after the first year curriculum that will help the student to have practical experiences in the industry. Now in pandemic mode, it can be online or offline, but it would be real industry work. Plus, in the final semester, fourth sem, there is an opportunity for the students to undertake 2 professional electives. The electives are based on analytical domain that is really happening in the industry based on business analytics, like healthcare analytics, financial analytics, marketing analytics, social media analytics, you name it. We have been able to put it in the curriculum so that the real taste of the industry is developed among students. To tell you honestly, at the outset of the development or starting of our classes, every weekend we try to engage students with expert lecture sessions, experts from academia as well as from the industry, and they provide real organizational case studies. They go through as well as real organizational examples. We have it currently through webinar. Maybe in future we'll have those sessions live, hopefully. So in a nutshell, we are trying to focus more and more to bridge the gap between the industry demand as well as the PO theory. And hopefully it will work well.
Thank you, sir. That was a very clear insight into the functioning of the institute itself. So my next question would be, how do you ensure a healthy relationship between the faculty and the students?
normally in the entire college curriculum, the concept of alumni meet, social, cultural, picnic fest, these are all there, where there are enough opportunities for the students to interact with the faculties and other peer groups and stakeholders. And now in this pandemic scenario, for the last 1 to 1.5 years, we are having that level of crisis. But to tell you honestly, we have developed a breach course for student faculty interaction. We understand that our students are from diverse background, some from commerce, some from engineering, some from science. So we have developed a breach course which will help to minimize the gap between what they would need to learn in the main course plus what they lack in some, if the students lack in some respect in terms of skills, that would also be minimized. Therein, students also have the opportunity to interact with faculties in a big way, in a more informal manner. In fact, in our second semester curriculum, we have a paper named Personality Development Lab. English, it's more related to organizational behavior and English communication, Personality Development Lab, where the students have enough opportunity to open up and be confident. There would be enough opportunity. So in this way, we are trying extremely hard to make a proper student-faculty interaction go well. It becomes healthy. In fact, we have a system of induction program every year. Now, for the last 1 year, it's happening in online mode, but we have a proper system in really 2-3 weeks, entire structure of induction program where the students are entirely introduced to the course, to the curriculum. They visit all the labs, all the facilities, and they understand the entire procedure of the organization. So in a nutshell, we are thinking in that line so that we can develop the healthy student-faculty relationship.
Yes.
We understand that they are extremely matured enough. This is a postgraduate course and they have high expectations. And we cannot treat them like a plus two or an undergraduate student. This is a most high-end postgraduate course. So in that way, the faculties and the students work side by side. Hopefully it will be a proper result in the future.
I'm sure this interview will give a very deep understanding of how healthy and how nurturing the college is towards students. So my last question would be a very important one. What are the benefits and career opportunities available after pursuing this course?
Now, if we look at a macro level, if we see the general, a big McKinsey report, they have mentioned that there are a lack of 1.5 lakh to 2 lakh people who have proper understanding of deep analytical skills, even in the US market. So if that is the scenario in the US market, we can easily understand the kind of openings and opportunities we have in a developing market like India. Learning MBA in business analytics from a premier autonomous institution is a big achievement itself. And our course is focused on graduates or IT computer professionals who can work in the domain of analytics, in the service areas, in client relationship, as well as in core management areas where analytics is useful, like marketing, finance, HR, or supply chain management. If you say about the job designation and title, they can be data analyst, business analyst, data manager, business intelligence expert, MIS executive, data science, data scientist, who can leverage skills. And there are organizations who look for those candidates. It's an extremely upcoming domain. There are opportunities in healthcare, government service, public distribution, risk management, IT sectors, marketing. There are opportunities. Some of the premier organizations who provide employment in business analytics, some of them, namely, there are JP Morgan, the entire Tata Group, SBI, ICICI, Morgan Stanley, IBM, Accenture, Wipro, you name it. I am just giving you a small description, but it's an entire gamut of organization. And since it is an upcoming dominant field, the subject is itself only 7 to 8 years old. So you can easily understand there are many upcoming organizations who look for proper business analysts who would be able to leverage the data, programming and coding, and make informed decisions for the organization and for the clients in all respect. And it's bound to grow. Whether there is pandemic or no pandemic, this market is bound to grow in absolute totality. So there is extremely high level of career opportunities for students. They can opt for, they can look for it. And in case of MCKB, we are one of its kind. This course is one of its kind in entire Eastern India. Okay, and you cannot find this level of curriculum and course entirely in the entire Eastern market of India. So this is an area, this is an organization where students can think to pursue their career in terms of analytics and big data.
Absolutely, sir. So the kind of facilities that your college has and with the kind of industry connect, I'm sure students will find immense growth opportunities and career opportunities for their lifetime. So thank you for your valuable time here for giving this interview. So we are done.
It's my pleasure that College Duniya has invited us, and I hope that this information percolates throughout the country through different channels. And we come to the focus because we want to serve our clients. We want to serve students. We are here for an opportunity for the students.
Yes.
And that too in absolute PPO domain. It's not a normal MBA like marketing, finance and HR. It's entirely business analytics, which is a big upcoming domain. It is the future for students.
Yes, sir. So, direct interview with the faculty members themselves gives a very clear understanding and shapes the perception about the college itself. So, thank you so much, sir.